and for more on when these fires might let up and what can be done to help prevent them in the future, let's go to our chief meteorologist, Ginger Z. Ginger, good morning.
Oh, Diane, I wish I had different news, but the immediate future looks pretty bleak, especially in Napa Valley, where that glass fire is still burning. I was talking to a friend yesterday in Rutherford, and even though she's not in mandatory evacuation zone, they had to leave because the smoke's so thick. And so let's focus in on the Bay Area, especially there north, where those red flag warnings are still up. At night, it's really difficult because the relative humidity drops to below 10%. That means very dry conditions, and then the winds could gust to 40 miles per hour. It's also very hot during the day. Look at San Jose, still up at 97. So you're going to have a problem there until Friday. That's when those red flag warnings start to lift and we see a bit of a shift in the wind. And that's going to help air quality too, likely. Excessive heat warnings in Southern California, so the Bobcat and other small fires that are burning, going to be really tough to fight. I mean, Long Beach was a record 105. Those excessive heat warnings are going to stick around for a day or two, but things are going to start to improve by the end of the weekend temperature-wise. So this whole ridge that's been in place is going to just give up just a little from north to south, but not as much south. You can see Palm Springs, which had hottest summer, hottest September on record, Burbank dropping to only 92, but Sacramento gets a good 15 to 20 degree drop. We also have to talk about this because we've been talking about how epic this season has been, right? 3.9 million acres burned. Just to give you perspective, our previous record of acreage burned was 1.8 million. So now we're talking about two times. It's really, really big numbers. And the next natural question is, what is the cause? And this is what I'm going to hit, and it's not too late. That is what we do tonight on ABC News Live here with Lindsay Davis. I do an environmental or a climate story every week, and this week I'm going to be fact-checking and giving some context to the climate section of the debate. Now, a climate moderator has not asked a question about climate change in 12 years of presidential debates, so we were grateful that it happened. But of course, we could learn a bit more. Wildfires was hit pretty hard, and I think climate change related to wildfire is important. So listen to Daniel Swain.
I think this really speaks to how counterintuitively large the effects of just a few degrees of warming have been in certain sectors. And I think the wildfire crisis in California and other parts of the West is one of these places where the impacts of seemingly incremental climate warming are not incremental at all. I think a lot of folks have correctly characterized the wildfire situation in the past 5 or 10 years in California as a step change, not the new normal, but the new abnormal, because it still appears to be getting worse pretty quickly rather than stabilizing at this point.
As important as it is to note that the heat dries out the foliage and that prolonged period is related to climate change, one of the other major problems is forest management. So when President Trump talked about that, he was right. They have to change the way they manage the forests.
It does not mean cutting down forests. It does not mean raking the forest floor. It means essentially emulating natural fire processes. Fire in itself is not an inherently bad thing to some degree or another. And so we've excluded it from a lot of these ecosystems completely for too long. And so really the goal is to reintroduce it in a way that improves ecosystem health, that reduces risk to urban areas, that reduces these massive smoke plumes that cause these choking smoke storms in urban areas.
And that's just it. It's a complex issue, climate change, forest management, but there's also sustainability and the way we build and where we build. And that's something else that we will be addressing in future It's Not Too Late segments. I hope you'll watch tonight. And for now, head back to Diane.
Thanks, Ginger. And you can hear Ginger's full report tonight on ABC News Live Prime at 7 p.m. Eastern.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.